tearing it up. I can't put the gut, I make them a chucker. Come through like disco disaster. I set the pace to make it go faster.
I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. The winding road to the Super Bowl continues here in the divisional round, where two teams look to take another step towards the Super Bowl. It's the Eagles going up against the Redskins. We're in for Bridget One in Philadelphia, as it's off the Lincoln Financial Field to say hello to our veteran broadcasters, Jim Nance and Bill Sims.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we're here today for a matchup in which one team, Jim Nance along with Bill Sims, getting set for this divisional round matchup. Kickoff just minutes away.
Yeah, every round of the playoffs, it just gets bigger. Everybody gets more excited, more attention drawn, or thrown at these players, I should say. How do you handle it? Can you keep your nerves? Coaches, can you make decisions on that sideline that does not hurt your football team?
The Redskins setting up here for the kickoff. The Eagles are back deep, waiting to return the kick. We kick off this game. The winner heads on to the conference championship title game. And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line. And now we've got what you'd call the wily veteran at quarterback, about to head onto the field for the first time today.
Yeah, when you're a quarterback like this and you've had success, you go out in the field, you can't wait for the game to start, because you veterans think only good things are going to happen to them. So they're confident and ready to go.
The Redskins come out in a dime package. He's brought down at the 20-yard line. And the offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches. The Eagles come to the line with an empty backfield. Out of the shotgun formation. Has Gordon. Gets about nine on the play.
The slant route is not used as much as it used to be in the NFL, because defensive linemen read quarterbacks now better than ever, and they jump up to knock those passes down. But that time they didn't get it done. The slant route is caught. It comes up a couple of yards short of the first down.
Moore's there to take it down.
So many times you watch football games and coaches just give up too early on the run game. Well, they'll keep it going today after that run. Decent pickup by the running back.
First and 10. They want to keep feeding him the football. That's a gain of 10.
You're running back in this league and you pick up first downs. If you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
The Eagles will take the snap from the 45. And they get the sack.
Well, every defense is looking for somebody to sack the quarterback, and that time, the speed of the defensive end gets around a tackle and gets the sack.
Three-step drop, and it's complete to Josh Gordon.
I know it looks easy, but it's not. But a nice throw on the slant route. Slant route means you're slanting towards the inside. Good throw and catch.
The Eagles will look to get down. Catch made. Oh, he picks up the first.
Now, if you want to keep your place on the offense, then catch the pass and break a tackle and get some extra yards. That's what the guy did on that play. Nice job by him.
The Eagles have it at the 44. And it's swatted away. Here are the starters today on defense. Failing to complete that one, so second down here. Puts a hand. Oh, he made the catch. He caught it with one hand. In the red zone. Here's the first snap after the big play. He'll go ground. And find space. And this will be a loss of one on the play.
What a job by the defense down on the goal line. They were playing run all the way. It was a run. They got the penetration, and they tackled the runner for a loss.
A first drive, and a first touchdown.
When you're in a divisional round of the playoffs, the pressure builds, the teams get tight, but when you're the first one to score like that, wow, what a boost. It makes you feel great. Let the other team chase you.
The Redskins ready to return the kick. Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. And now we've got a young quarterback about to head onto the field for the first time today.
Jim, this guy, he's starting to inch his way up into that elite status, and he keeps playing solid football. So if he goes out here today and plays a good, solid game again today, we're gonna start talking about him differently here in the future.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. He's going to be tackled right around the 21-yard line. This is a collection of wide receivers that could dictate this game today. They must find a way to create separation for their quarterback. Second and nine. Looking across the middle. And he's tackled down after picking up the first. Can you believe how steady and reliable this guy is?
What's the phrase for it? He is money, Jim Nance. Man, he pays off every single time. You throw the football near him, he'll make the catch.
First and 10. Has his target. He'll pick up seven this time.
Nice job that time of the tight end. Makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
The Redskins take it from the 38. Handoff out of the eye. And here's a look at the defensive line that will try to control the trenches today. 2 minutes to go, first quarter, third down. Step in. They saw a little bit of movement on that offensive front, and that'll be a false start. That'll cost them five. Third down after the penalty. Allen's got the catch and the first. That is how you draw it up, isn't it, Phil?
Oh, man, a quarterback loves guys that can make catches like this, and they're just so strong. They know how to zero in. They never lose concentration, and you never see them drop a pass.
Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. coming to the line at the 44.
The Redskins in the pistol. First down at the 44.
For a gain of about five.
And it's now second down and five after running it on first down.
He'll get it again. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Redskins offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens to run, loses yards, that's just a bad job of the offensive line.
It's a two tight end formation.
Warbus on the receiving end. Gains 17.
Well, if you guard the tight end close, it sometimes that doesn't matter. They're so big and they got long arms, they can still make the catch. Quarterbacks give them a chance, they get it done.
The Redskins take it from the 23.
Wide to the left.
The Redskins now move the chains. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
It's a nice drive by the offense, Jim. They're down. They're driving down the field. Let's see if they can put 7 points on the board.
The Eagles lined up in the nickel. False start on the offense will set them back.
False start, offense.
This long drive continues. The Redskins will come out in the pistol. First and goal. Here's the running play. Off tackle. Gains 13. Offense heading to the line for the 11th play of the drive. One last play before the quarter ends. Second and goal from the one. The Redskins' offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway.
This has been a nice little drive by the offense. They started out in bad field position. Look at them now inside the red zone. Let's see if they can pay it off.
Mitchell's an infraction. Defense.
But the referees say it's on the defense. Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. And the second quarter breaks the plane. Touchdown. And it didn't take long for them to get this game right back to even here in the second quarter.
Yeah, that was a nice drive on the offensive side. That makes you feel good. And you just to execute so many plays and find a way to get down there and score a touchdown.
Got a tie game here now and what's been a good one so far. The score's 7-7. That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. The Eagles getting set to take over again on offense. They'll be trying to pick it up right where they left off with their last drive that ended in a touchdown.
Yeah, they throw the football well. And I'll tell you, I've been covering this game a long time. There's still nothing.
McCoy takes down the quarterback.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback, and the best person to do it is the defensive end. What a good job that time by him.
From the gun. He's got a wide open alley. Moore's there to make the tackle. The Redskins will come out in the dime. The Eagles from the 37. Getting away from the pressure. Jones has got it. And a first.
Well, the quarterback has such great confidence in the receiver. And why not? He's talented. And every time the football is thrown his way, he finds a way to make the catch.
Gonna try and scramble now. With the contact, the ball comes out.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, they can make a big play.
The Redskins defense now is going to go nickel. They'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. And that's a gain of 10. Partner looking at the stats. It's a tie game here in the first half, but the passing attack has looked strong. So that's big moving forward.
Got to be happy with the passing attack so far in this game. The quarterback has great confidence, and why not? He's won the...
Intercepted! Tackle's made. There's going to be an injury timeout here. We'll take a quick break and be back in just a moment. Danielle Bellini is working to get us an update on that injury as soon as possible. The Redskins from the 27, looking for some daylight up the middle. And tackled down at the 43-yard line.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
The Eagles with a nickel look here on defense. First down and 10. The give. And this will end up as a 2-yard loss. Redskins snapping at the 41. That's a tackle at the 48. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day. We've had a very close game to this point, but if you look at the rushing numbers in a tie game, you have to be optimistic because you see a running back that right now is having it his way.
The fans love it. They're watching this team run the football. They're doing an extraordinary job of doing it well. And I know who else loves it. Fantasy football player. Seeing a guy play this well and run it this good, man, that's good stuff. Hard to guard these tight ends now in the NFL. It really puts the defense in like a quandary. Do we use a big guy? Well, the big guy's not fast enough. We use a small guy? Well, he's not big enough. They get pushed around. I don't know what you're going to do. Just make sure you're a good tackler after they catch it.
Entrenchment defense. Still first down.
Here they come to the 41-yard line. First and 5. They'll run it here. And they'll end up losing 4 here.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Quarters formation here for the defense. The Redskins will take the snap from the 45. Gains 16. First down here after the run. They'll go ground. Picks up 7.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Redskins from the 22. He's going to be tackled right around the 21-yard line. Here they come to the line of scrimmage, the 21-yard line. Third down and 2. The ball is fumbled. He's in the clear. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Touchdown.
This defense has some mentality, don't they? Not only do they want turnovers, they want points to go with it. Nice job of taking it all the way back for the touchdown.
the Eagles for the extra point. The point after is good. The Redskins ready to return the kick.
Makes the catch at the 7. Halftime is coming up, but first we reach the 2-minute warning. And now as we head back to the field, we've got an offense trying to get some momentum going before the first half draws to a close. They'll go shotgun here. Finds his mark. That's a gain of 10.
If you think you can get a playoff quickly and not use a timeout, you go with a hurry-up offense. That time, a good job by the coach and the quarterback.
Second down now.
I like this decision by the coach to go with the hurry-up offense here late in the first half. You can't be worried about making mistakes.
Pass is intercepted.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Redskins go with the dime formation here on defense. Looking long to Julio Jones, and they can't connect.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Running away from the pressure. Jones going to pull in the bullet pass.
Do the little things right. When you do those right, you get big victories. And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances. Really good job by the offensive player.
And now he'll take the snap and just surge ahead. Second down coming up with about a minute to go before intermission. Second down and 8. Now on the move. Down the field. And intercepted.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Redskins will try to hold on to the football. This has been one big turnover after another, Phil. Just what the coaches talked about in our meetings with him this week about ball security. It's not happening here.
Well, it tells you the players did not listen to the coaches, that's for sure, because ball security is not what we're seeing out there. I know this. Next week in practice, there's going to be a lot of drills about hanging on to the football.
First down at the 37. Benjamin makes the catch. The Redskins are going to use one of the 2 timeouts they have remaining. After that grab, it's now second down and 2. The Eagles defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Handoff. That's a tackle right near the 48. First down here.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up. Get that football snap. Conserve time.
Intercepted. Breaks the tackle.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did. They got the interception.
First down at the 46. That gains a few. The Eagles elect to take a timeout here before the second down snap. After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. Away from the pressure. Going to be a penalty here. Taken down at the 27.
Holding offense.
The defense accepts the penalty. After that penalty, it sets up second down and 18.
This will probably be the last play of the first half. Scrambling out of the pocket. Middle of the field and incomplete this time. That'll do it for the first half. We'll be sending you to Larry Ridley back in our studios as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports.
No return. The ball's coming out to the 20.
The Eagles have done a great job today forcing turnovers, Phil.
They have caught this offense off guard, no doubt. They have shown some new schemes on the defensive side. It surprised the offense, and it's led to turnovers.
Quarter begins with this play. Gets about 4 yards that time.
Well, there's not much to say about that play, Jim. It was a completion by the quarterback, and it picked up a couple yards.
Get ready. Break 38. Break 38.
Second and six. To the ground. Picks up about two.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage.
The grab is made by Kelvin Benjamin.
The Redskins did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind in the second half. You keep looking at what does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Handoff made. And he gains maybe three.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting. And they hold the running back to a short gain.
Get ready. Break 38.
The Redskins will take the snap from the 40. The tackle's made and the first down is picked up. Double tight end formation. Now first and 10. Fullback takes the handoff.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
The Eagles with two extra defensive backs in the dime. Second down and 11. He has the grab.
Sometimes you got to give the coaches credit. They design a play that's smart, easy for the players to manage, and what we got there is a throw and a catch, and now they have a pretty good chance of getting the first down.
The Redskins take it from the 43. That's been the story of this game. Another third down conversion to move the chains.
Redskins look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
First down at the 34. They are all over him, behind the line of scrimmage, and a loss of one.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Breaking huddle at the 35-yard line.
Get ready. Three.
Second and 11. He'll get it again. And that's a 2-yard gain. This drive now about to reach the 10th play of the series. Redskins take it from the 33. And there's a drop.
Got to give this secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The Redskins call for the punt. And he punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds, trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. The Eagles' offense takes the field. Let's see if this momentum can carry over from the first half, because they have been brilliant to this point, partner.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you've got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half.
The Eagles will take the snap from the 30. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
The Eagles running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play, what happens? He gets tackled for a loss. What a job by the defender that time, reading the quarterback and the receiver and being in position to knock that football away. That is really well played. That's a clinic. Put that on the highlight film and show guys how to do it.
They'll take it at the 20. The Redskins bringing their offense onto the field and coming off a previous possession. This started out with a lot of promise, but ended up with a punt.
Well, there's nothing worse on the offensive side. Playing quarterback in the NFL, when you start moving the football, you're just thinking, oh, this is going to end in a touchdown or at least a field goal. And that did not happen on the offensive side, so there's got to be a little self-doubt right now.
Let's see if the playmakers on this offense can step up on this series.
I hope so. They sure need to.
The Redskins from the 27. Stands in the pocket. Incomplete. Looking at the passing numbers on both sides of the ball, they're just not there. The coverage has been good and has been hard to move the ball against those secondaries.
Yeah, good job for the defense today. They got a good pass rush going. The coverage has been good down the field. And also, the defense has been good, but the quarterback has not been real sharp.
The Redskins from the 27. Set up screen. This offense can't be stopped on third down, no matter the distance.
Redskins, good job that time, moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. The Eagles lined up in the nickel. The quarterback with the give to the fullback. Now looking at third down. The Eagles defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. The Redskins get a first down. That's his 6th catch of the day.
The Redskins just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial.
You knew this was going to happen, and the coach disagrees with the call on the field. There's no question he caught the ball, but there is a question whether or not he got both feet in bounds.
Well, first off, you want to make sure it's a clean catch on the sidelines. Does he have possession of the football? And then once you declare he has possession of the football, let's look down at both feet, see if they're in bounds, and don't forget, you must maintain possession of the football as you go to the ground.
So the coach's challenge backfires. They'll lose the timeout.
and they failed to overturn the call on the field.
You know what you do in situations like this? You fire the guy upstairs who told him, throw the flag, coach. Well, what do you got to say now? It was a terrible call, terrible decision, and you lose a timeout.
First down at the 41. And the pass is thrown away. It's now second down. Here's the handoff. Ball was out, and the offense was able to recover the ball.
One thing coaches hate when their offense is on the field is fumbling the football, because a lot of times it's just bad fundamentals. But they're lucky this time they had the fumble. They're able to get on top of it.
Third and seven. Brings it into his body.
Redskins did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind in the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
They come to the line of scrimmage at the 20. They bring in the extra tight end. The final quarter underway now with this snap. He will not get away. He's taken down for the sack.
Outside linebackers who can get to the quarterback, they are a rare breed in the NFL, because it takes talent, size, speed, everything to do it as a linebacker. And we saw it that time on display.
The Redskins will take the snap from the 25.
Some good play calls so far in this drive by the offensive coordinator. His team is down, but they are marching down the field. When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
First and goal from the 7. Tackles made.
That was a good idea that time by the offensive coordinator, trying to go with the run game here in the fourth quarter when they're only down one score. Defense was ready and stopped it for a short game.
Second and goal from the 7. Gets it again. And a gain of 4.
Well, before we see this third goal situation here, Jim, in the second half, we know a touchdown ties the game. If they don't make it, are they willing to go for it on fourth down?
Third and goal from the 3. Powers his way across. Touchdown. And that touchdown ties the game just moments into this final quarter. It's shaping up to be a dramatic conclusion to this contest.
I know one thing. It has fired up the crowd. There's no question about that. They are excited. They got a tie game here in the fourth quarter. And this is going to be emotional down the stretch.
Touchback here. We'll bring the ball out to the 20. The Eagles offense failed to muster a single first down the last time they had it. Let's see if their offense this time can create a few sparks.
Well, you know, the coaches were upset at them when they went to the sideline, so the sense of urgency is there. You should be fired up, and I expect a better drive this time. Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. He's tackled at the 30.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
First and 10. He's scrambling now. Going for the home run, and it's incomplete.
And quarterbacks love to throw the football high and far down the field. That time, the quarterback doesn't do that, and he underthrows the receiver.
Second and 10. And now he'll take off. Looking long. Has the catch.
see this more and more in the NFL, don't we, Jim? Quarterbacks who move around just enough. That time he gets outside the pocket and does a beautiful job of completing a deep pass down the field.
He is tackled at the 40-yard line. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Second down and 9. It's wide open.
Coming to the line at the 24.
First and 10.
Gets the handle here.
Slashes to the left side. Gains 5.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done. When we were in practice on Friday, Jim, this team was working on red zone offense all the time. Well, here they are. It's a tie game. We'll see if all that practice pays off. The Eagles offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job at the offensive line.
Loss of a couple that time from the gun. Looking to go down the field here.
This will be a 38-yard field goal attempt.
And the kick is good for 3.
That field goal puts them in a great position to win the game. The defense now will be rallying, trying to make a stop.
Okay, yeah, you know, the good thing is they got the lead. We're in the fourth quarter, but in the back of your mind, you have to think, wow, we really could have used 7, and you worry that that 3 points is going to come back to haunt you.
That return's good for about 18. The Redskins offense preparing to get this drive underway. The last possession ended in a touchdown. Phil, let's see if they can do it again.
Very well done. Loved what I saw out there on the offense the last time. They mixed it up and they showed a lot of confidence. You can see the speed of the football team and try to duplicate what they just did. That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Second down and 10. Screen brings it in. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment. We're back now as the defense will try to keep the offense off the board. Late here in the fourth.
First down and 10.
He'll throw it over the middle. Can't find the target on the pass underneath.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
The Redskins take it from the 38. Allen with the reception. Pick up about 4. Coming up, third down. A huge moment.
Always try to save the timeout or timeouts when you can. And one way to do it is go to the hurry-up offense. Good job.
There's the offense picking up another first down on third down. We've got a player down, so we'll step aside and be back in just a moment. First down. Pressure on every snap now. The Redskins from the 37. Delayed handoff. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. Play number 6 coming up on this drive.
You know, when you push the tempo late in the game and you're down a few points, it makes the defense kind of react instead of attacking you, and I think you have a much better chance in a hurry-up offense of trying to score in these situations.
Holding on to the timeout. They'll rush back to the line. Reaches out and grabs it. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. The Eagles, 1 timeout remaining. This is where a kicker makes his living. With all the pressure, the game just a field goal away from being tied. the field goal attempt is good. It's good. Very clutch. The long field goal to tie the game in the last 2 minutes. They could have taken the lead with that drive, but they get the field goal in the clutch by the kicker.
Yeah, nice job. You're right. Doing it in the clutch, and it doesn't matter how far it is. Your teammates, they expect you to make it, and the kicker got it done.
The Eagles take the field. The game is tied. And can this offense drive down and win it for them?
Yeah, you got to be alert on the offensive side in situations like this. The defense knows they can't give up yards and they can't give up points. So look for them to take chances and be very aggressive.
The Eagles will need to get to about the 35 on this drive in order to kick a field goal. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Brought down at the 47-yard line. The Eagles head to the line. They've got one timeout left in the game. Time continues to tick away as they'll rush back to the line.
Well, when you get in a situation like this, Jim, and you get third and long, I'll tell you what catches a defense by surprise. Run a double move on the outside against the defensive back, because everybody in the stands and the defensive players all think you're going to throw it short.
Gets it out for the completion. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Redskins in a tie game will call a timeout. They clearly want the ball back with a chance to do something. The Eagles now will attempt to take the lead. And to do so, they must make the field goal from long distance. Puts it through the uprights. Needed plenty of leg on that one. They were thinking touchdown that entire drive, but in the end, they have to go field goal. They convert here in the closing stages.
Well, I'm sure they would have loved to kick that field goal as time expired, but that's not the case. Good job of moving the football down the field, getting that field goal to put them ahead, and now the defense, go out there and do your job.
The Redskins offense comes out here, Phil, desperately looking to put a drive together that can give them a chance here late to win this game.
Always the tough thing to do in a situation like this for the offense is don't try to make the big play. Let it happen. Take a short gain if that's what the defense is giving you, especially on first down. Get this drive started by doing the right thing.
Second and 10. And it's complete to Keenan Allen. And that's a gain of 13. The Redskins with the timeout. They want to make sure they're on the same page for this final snap. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Scanning the field. And it's going to fall incomplete. Their comeback effort comes up short. One team's hopes have been dashed. The other gets to live for another week and one step away from a possible Super Bowl. Heading on to the conference championship next week. When you win in this round, you win in the divisional round. You know now they're just one more victory away from the Super Bowl stage. What a victory here today.
It is. That dream that you have of going to the Super Bowl, we got a lot closer after today's game. And to beat such a quality opponent gives you confidence.
Hear the color. Push
everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. With a spot in the Super Bowl on the line, everything is on the line in today's conference championship matchup. It's the Eagles going up against the Saints. We're in for Frigid One in Philadelphia as it's off to Lincoln Financial Field to say hello to our veteran broadcasters, Jim Nance and Phil Sims.
The NFC Championship game coming up next here on EA Sports.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Phil Sims, and welcome to the NFC Championship game. Whole lot at stake here. The winner moves on to the Super Bowl. And Phil, your thoughts before kickoff?
Well, we know it's a big game, don't we, Jim? I mean, listen, up here in the booth, you and I, we're both a little nervous, and we're not even playing it. That's how big it is to think that you're one step away from the Super Bowl. But just do your job. Think about what you have to do each play. If you do that, that'll take away the nerves and also keep you from making that big mistake.
The Saints ready to get this action started. The Eagles are back deep, ready to return the kickoff. And here we go. The conference championship underway. The winner heads to the Super Bowl. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33, maybe the 34-yard line. And here's a quarterback coming onto the field who has plenty of experience under his belt.
Yep, there's no doubt. He is the man in charge, and he shows it just the way he handles himself. And that's why he plays so well. That's why he's in this game today.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. First down at the 34. They're setting up screen. Going to take it the distance. The 10. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
Nothing like scoring first in a conference championship game. I'm not a big stats guy, but your chances of winning when you score first in a conference championship, your chances of winning are about 85%. How about that?
The Eagles for the extra point. Extra point is good. And no return this time as he takes a knee. Mannion's coming on now. He'll be guiding the Saints today.
Let's go.
First down at the 20. We'll go ground. And that gains a few. Here's a look at the offensive unit that needs to get off to a strong start today. It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. The Saints lined up, bunch formation. Secures it with two hands. And he's brought to the ground. From the red zone. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Power surge for 6. Touchdown. They answer right back, Phil, with a touchdown of their own in the early going.
Yeah, a lot of confidence down there in the field on both sides. And the offenses, they got to be feeling good. Here you are tied early in the game, first quarter, and this could be an offensive explosion here today.
Now ready to kick it off as we have a tie game here. Scores 7-7. Just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Eagles coming back onto the field on offense. They took it down the field for a touchdown the last time they had it.
Listen, momentum is on their side. When you have that going for you,
and he's thrown to the ground. The Eagles' offensive line could be in for a long day based on that one.
Yeah, bad job that time. They give up the sack. But look, when you talk about this offensive line, they're pretty good. So I think they'll just find a way to get it done. They still should have a nice, solid day.
A reception on second down, but not enough for the first. Third down. Throws the pass. Intercepted. He's brought to a halt. The Saints offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
Nothing there as this goes for a loss of two.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Let's go.
The Saints have it at the 29. We give. Davis tackled down at the 29. Here's a look at the defense with its ball-hawking secondary. Third down now. Mannion's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Has the touchdown, Saints. That's a big way to get the momentum in your favor with that touchdown, Phil.
Yeah, nothing like it. Midway through the first quarter, you're on top of the other team, and you just feel like, hey, we got things under control, and you're putting pressure on the opposition to go out there and try to make something happen.
The Saints are ready to kick it away. Takes off from the five. Shrugs off the first hit. And it's the same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. The Eagles offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go. Go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
First down here after the completion. Dropping back now into the shotgun. And he's tackled at the 32-yard line. And the offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches. The Eagles from the 32. And the QB is hit and dropped by Short.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad after getting sacked like that by the defensive end. Your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
Loss of four on the play.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Intercepted. He's brought down.
Well, nowadays, your linebackers, they...
As with all turnovers, play is stopped now as the crew wants to confirm whether or not that was, in fact, an interception.
Well, that was an awesome play by the defense that time, getting the interception. Now, they turn into receivers once they get the interception. Did he have possession of the football? We'll find out.
A
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Took a moment for them to validate it, but the word comes back from the replay booth. The play on the field will stand. The Saints from the 32. They'll run it here.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
He'll take the snap from the gun. And he hauls it in. That's his first reception today.
Nice catch by the receiver, but it still doesn't get a first down.
The Saints from the 22. Davis is going to take the handoff now. Player is down on the field, and the training staff comes out, and we'll step aside for just a moment. Drives it through for the field goal. That field goal widens the gap here after one, Phil.
Jim, they have everything going right now in their favor. They're confident, they're playing well, they're emotional, everything you want as a football team. They got it done here in the first quarter.
Free kick out of bounds, kicking team.
Sloppy mistake here. That kick travels out of bounds.
Automatic first down.
Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has the injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with an Eagles official. At this point, the medical staff is going to hold him out of this one with what they're still just calling an upper body injury. So, guys, he's out for the day. Back to you.
Here's the defense, a unit that works best when it gets to the quarterback. They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Away from the ball, there's a flag coming on the field. And that's a gain of maybe five.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty. Following the penalty, it sets up second down and 19. Two tight ends on the field here. Julio Jones with the grab. Fights through contact. That's his first reception today.
My gosh, the wide receivers in the NFL now, it's incredible. It's not that you have one. Every team has two and three, and some have four. Good job that time by him hauling in that pass.
First down at the 42. Looking across the middle. And that'll be a gain of about two.
Well, they complete the pass, Jim, but doesn't get the first down. Sooner or later, you got to throw one down the field.
The Eagles will take the snap from the 40. And incomplete pass that time as he threw it short.
Well, when you see a throw that bad, there's a couple things that can happen. Maybe a defensive player flashed in front of him, or maybe the quarterback just lost control of the football.
He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Got the completion. And he's going to be tackled right around the 31-yard line.
When the football's in the air, the receiver on the curl route has to see it and come back towards the quarterback. That's what he did that time. That's why they got the completion.
The Eagles snapping at the 31. He runs with it right up the gut. Able to take the football out to the 28-yard line. The Eagles on offense here to start the second quarter. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Scrambling now. And that pass is just thrown away.
Well, every play is not going to be a masterpiece. This time the quarterback broke out of the pocket. He doesn't find anything he likes. So he makes a good, quick decision, gets rid of the football.
Third down and 7. Takes the hit, throws. This will be a field goal attempt from 45 yards out. No doubt about it. Put 3 on the board. That field goal narrows the gap here in the early part of the second quarter, Phil.
Yeah, it was a good drive, Jim, that time. It's a morale booster. It gives you energy. It did everything for your football team. I know it was just a field goal, but I thought it was very important for the football team.
Brought down at the 26. That return's good for about 24. The Saints stepping back onto the field to get this next drive underway. The previous possession was a field goal.
Yeah, I think they feel good about that field goal. They made some good plays, and they got down there, and they moved the football, and they got in position where they could kick the field goal. Now you take the knowledge that you gained from that last drive, use it, and try to go down there now and score a touchdown.
They've got to be wondering, though, can they finish off a drive today?
Let's go!
Second down and 4. They'll go ground. Wide to the left. Into the open.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing. You're going to...
Let's go!
First down at the 48. The Saints now move the chains.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. The Saints have it at the 39, trying to plow ahead.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short gain.
Let's go.
The Saints take it from the 38. Davis taking the handoff. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Davis is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
First down at the 28. And they go back to the ground. That picks up 11.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
For this play, they'll go with 2 tight ends. Now first and 10. Leaning on that running attack again here. Takes it the distance for the touchdown. They continue to add to their lead, Phil, late in the second quarter. And so far, there's been no looking back.
Yeah, it's all working on the offensive side. And listen, don't take this for granted. Stay aggressive. Keep putting the throw the keep throwing that gas on the fire. Pedal to the metal. Whatever cliche you want to use, use it and keep the pressure on.
To move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Eagles bring their offense onto the field. The last time they had control of the football, they did not come away empty-handed, but did not get a touchdown either.
Well, they got that field goal, and I think that's important. That field goal gave them a little confidence. They got some points up there that always makes you feel good on the offensive side. Now take advantage of that good feeling. Go out there and score a touchdown this time.
Let's see if they can finish off a drive. The gun. Jones has got the catch and the first. That's his 3rd catch of the day. They come to the line and it's first down. They'll hike it to him out of the shotgun. Takes off with it. Jordan Matthews brings it in. Matthews is tackled down after a gain of 12.
Well, it was an awesome job that time by the quarterback getting out of the pocket. He keeps the play alive and able to throw it down the field for a nice completion.
First down at the 34.
And he takes off. Gordon's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
The Eagles coaching staff has done a good job of mixing things up today on first down. The pass catches the defense off guard. They pick up solid yards. Now it's second and short.
The Eagles will take the snap from the 25.
Two hands on the football and has the catch.
Well, you get a couple first downs on a drive. It just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller, and there's nothing like dictating to the defense. I love it.
They deck him in the backfield. Second down coming up. This will probably be the last play before the two-minute warning. Just a quick drop back.
Ball is out.
They recover their own fumble. Two-minute warning. We're back, and we're coming out of the two-minute warning in the first half.
Here we go.
And now he'll surge ahead. Timeout called by the defensive unit. After that defensive timeout, we're ready for action.
Let's go.
Quarterback sneak. The Saints about to take over on offense, coming off a touchdown drive. Last time they had it, they really ran it up and down the field.
Yeah, you know what I would do on the offensive side? I would come out here and get in a run formation, and I would have a play-action pass because the defense is worried about stopping the run. If you show them a look where they think it's going to be run, they're going to dig in and try to do that. There should be somebody wide open down the field.
Second and nine coming up. It's a two tight end formation. Davis going to secure the handoff. Handoff. That's a timeout by the D. He's averaging about 40. Now third and five after the run. Mannion's setting up now in the pistol.
When I talk to young quarterbacks, I say the number one rule is always keep two hands on that football. That time, he doesn't do it. That's why when he got hit in the pocket, he fumbles it.
The Eagles offense now will try to sustain a drive after giving the ball away just a few minutes ago before their defense came up with a play to return the pigskin.
Man, they should thank the defense bailing them out of trouble getting that turnover. And you're right, they're just giving the football away, not being conscious of holding it the right way. It's just been sloppy play on the offense.
Goal line defense on the field.
Third and goal from the one.
And he's in for the touchdown. We're approaching halftime, and they put themselves in a great position to strike in the second half.
Just changed everything, didn't it? I mean, the way you and I look at the football game, but of course, it really changes the way the teams look at it. And that quick score, that puts you in a great frame of mind getting close to halftime.
He's got a chance to return this one.
Runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down.
The Saints are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You got to go out there and be much better.
There's going to be an injury timeout here. We'll take a quick break and be back in just a moment.
Second down after that pass play.
Let's go.
And a flag comes out.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
That's what happens when you try to guess the snap count. And Davis is lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. The defense gets the sack. The Eagles with no timeouts left. Third down on the way with 1 minute to go in the second quarter. Double tight end formation. Third down and 12. Davis got it on the handle.
Saints trying to catch the defense by surprise here on third and long. They go with the run, and sometimes those runs on third and long work, and you can pick up a first down. But that time the defense was ready, they tried it, and it didn't work.
He wants to return this one. And that's a gain of 9. Josh Gordon readying himself for this next possession.
He's not having any kind of impact on this game so far, and that's a big reason why his team's behind.
Yeah, when you talk about the run game, the pass protection, the run blocking, there's one word that comes to mind: poorly. Everybody's having a bad day, and especially the wide receiver. He's got to pick it up. He has the ability to raise the level of play of this offense just by his actions.
Back now at Lincoln Financial Field. Jim Nance, Bill Sims, Danielle Bellini for the beginning of the third quarter. And he's met head on right there at the 20. We've got a player down, so we'll step aside and be back in just a moment. Second half gets rolling now as he takes the snap. Picks up about 5. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Easy catch there. No one near him. They'll mark him at the 29. That's his first reception today.
That's what you want to do. Just get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving. Keep the defense guessing. Make them react instead of attack.
Mannion's 5 for 5 after that completion. Catch made. And that's a gain of 10.
Saints offense, they know it's more than just about their defense. The offense did a good job that time picking up the first down. That's what you want to do. You got a small lead in the second half. Keep getting those first downs and eat that clock up.
First down at the 19. Davis is tackled down at the 17.
Davis is trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. To the ground. Cox is the one who made the big stop.
Saints think they're doing a good job this time by running the football on second down. And what do? They lose a couple of yards. Now you have third long. You better be careful in this situation.
Mannion's got it in the gun. Has the grab. Third down has been a killer to them all day long.
I think that's playing it pretty safe, throwing that short pass on third and long. I thought he had a chance to throw it down the field. He just couldn't pull the trigger and let it go.
The kick is good. Midway third quarter and another 3 added to the lead, Phil. How about it?
Yeah, listen, it's been impressive. I like everything they're doing. That time they got down there and got the field goal. But on the other side, the coaching has been absolutely horrible, and you deserve to be losing.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
I saw the coach down on the sideline, and he is furious about that ball being kicked out of bounds.
Dude, I have no stake in this game. I'm mad, too. You got to kick it off. The field is 53 yards wide, and we couldn't kick it in between those 53 yards. It's like you hit the driver. You can't keep it on the fairway. Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
Second down and 10.
And it's batted down.
Well, Jim, now it's time. Even though it's third and long, you can't be over there, you know, playing it safe. That has not worked for you. Time to call a play, take a chance, and get that football down the field.
Getting away from the pressure. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
The Eagles don't want any part of punting the football. They're going to go for it on fourth down.
They bring in the extra tight end.
Has his target.
The Eagles that time go for it on fourth down, and they fail. I did not understand the decision. But you got to make sure your team doesn't get down from that. You got to keep them up.
The Saints have done a whale of a job taking their halftime lead and adding a whole lot more to it here in the third quarter.
And they're just doing everything we saw them do in the first half, just dominating the pace of play and just being more physical than the defense. That time shows a little power and breaks that tackle.
Started with practice back in July, training camps all through the regular season. This was the goal from the beginning, to advance to the Super Bowl. And they have done so today with their win in the NFC title game. So that's going to do it in this one. For Phil Simms and all the crew, we'll see you in 2 weeks at the Super Bowl.